Welcome, students. Today we are going to be exploring the topic of bearings. Now, by the end of the video, you should be able to define bearings, explain the importance of bearings, explain how to find a bearing, and how to use a protractor to find a bearing. So what is a compass or angular bearing? A bearing is a measurement of direction between two points. Now, when given a bearing, direction is indicated using angles. Angles are measured in a clockwise position from north. Here we can see on the compass that there are the angular bearings going around. They go around from 0 to 360 degrees in a clockwise direction. So why are bearings important? Bearings are important because they are a more precise way of giving direction. Now, captains of boats and yachts and ships have been using bearings to navigate for many, many years. And airplane pilots as well, they also use them to calculate flight angles and flight paths. So how do we find bearings? Well, to find a bearing, you must first place your protractor on the line or on the feature that is your starting point. In the example on the screen, you can it is A. You start with your protractor at zero, and you will locate B, the point which you are trying to locate, by following along the protractor until you reach your point. So you come down, come around to realize that this is your point here. Now, the angle at which B is located from A, so the bearing of B from A is 135 degrees. So continuing, how do we find bearings? Now, when locating or finding the bearing of a location or a feature which is located to the west of your location, because you are measuring clockwise, you will need to add more than 180 degrees. So you rotate your protractor to add that additional 180 degrees. And you continue counting, so 180, 190, 200, 210, 220, 230, 240, 250, 260, 270, 280, 290, 300, 310, 315. So the answer A from B equals 315 degrees. Finally, we will look at the do's and don'ts of compass bearings.
We are looking at the do's and don'ts of compass bearings and the correct technique to hold your protractor. Now, the first thing you want to do when you're finding the bearing is you want to place your protractor vertically. You don't want to start your bearing like this. This will give you an incorrect reading. You want to hold your protractor and start from the center of the object or building that you're doing your location from. If it's to the east, you hold your protractor to the 180 degrees. If the building or the location you're looking for is to the west of your protractor, then you turn it and you add another 180 degrees. So 180 plus 180 is 360 degrees.
So in conclusion, we have learned today that one, bearings are measurements of direction between two points. Two, bearings are important as they offer a more precise direction. Three, when finding a bearing, the protractor must start from zero. And if the feature or location is beyond the first 180 degrees, the protractor must be flipped. And lastly, the correct protractor technique is necessary for accurate bearing readings.